Are you ready to get rejected? That's right. That's a real question. Are you ready to get rejected? It's one of the age-old questions, and it has to do with regardless of whether you are a business person, an employee, a manager, or whether you are an entrepreneur, whatever you want to call it. Life is about relationships, and relationships are going to involve rejection. You are going to get rejected in life. I had a great friend call me today because this particular person was dealing with some rejection, and we went into some biblical sides of it, but we also talked about the practical sides of it. And so I kind of went through a few things with him, but the major principle I left with him, and I want to leave with you, and then I'll go through some other principles about rejection is, first and foremost, it's like one of the simple truths, and you can go back and look at the vlog. One of the simple truths that I talk about is that there are things that are in your control, and then there are things that are not. The things that are not in your control, ignore them. Just like rejection, you cannot control what the other person's going to do. I talk a lot about influence and persuasion, and there are ways to influence and persuade other people. That's what sales is all about. But ultimately, at the end of the day, the only thing you can do is influence and persuade yourself. That's what you have control over. So you are going to face rejection in your life. What do you do about that rejection? Guess what? Wait for it. Drum roll, ignore it. You got to ignore it. You've got to move on. Hey, listen, 100 calls a day, rejected 99 times, you get one. You got to ignore the other 99. If you're trying to build relationships with people, whether those are personal relationships or business relationships, you're going to get rejected. Not every relationship is meant to be, and you got to understand that. And you have to practice the ability to ignore the rejection. Because the rejection doesn't matter. A no just means you're closer to the next yes. That's what I always believe. A no today is you're closer to the next yes, whether that's personal or whether that's business. And so I want you to use a few of these proven business strategies, and I'm going to put them down in the comments so you can go through them. And first thing is that in order to banish your fear of rejection is you have to figure out specifically what you're afraid of. What are you afraid of? That goes back to that self-awareness piece. Next is feel the fear. You know, when I was having that conversation today with somebody, you know, they were like, well, you know, but I feel it. And I was like, yes, you do. You are going to feel it. You're going to feel that fear. You're going to feel the emotion of rejection. But that's okay because you'll recognize it more and more, just like when you go to the gym. If you go to the gym, you're going to feel getting sore every time you're working out. But you're gonna get used to it and you're gonna understand it and you're gonna know how to deal with it. Next is let go of others' responses to you. You cannot worry about others' reactions to you. You can only focus on what you have control over. Next is you can dispute your fear with facts. Always go with facts. What are the facts in this situation? I've got to minimize my emotions and go with the facts and be objective about what's happening. That's super critical to being on the offense against rejection and what rejection is trying to do, which is paralyze you. Don't let it happen. Lastly is try displaying some of the pleasant characteristics that may draw others into you, even though you have been rejected. So now what you've done is you've turned their offense into your offense. You've taken their rejection and now you've spun it to you're okay with it. As soon as you're okay with it and they recognize it, that puts a seed or plant in their mind of, well, maybe I should listen to them. Why? Why were they so okay with my rejection? It's okay to accept the other person's rejection and then use it to let them know you're okay with it because it will plant a seed. So that's my bit today. I'm at, let's see, 4 minutes and 30 seconds. So just wanted to come with you with a few truth moments today because had a very long conversation with a really good friend and we talked about rejection and I thought it may plant and help a few of you. So with all of our things that we do here at the ROYI Academy, which is about being the best version of you, is we end everything with saying that you are loved because everyone needs to hear at least once a day they're loved and you are loved. And that's from Rob Barber, the founder of ROYI Academy. And we'll see you next time. See ya.